Post-human nightmare, the data bank. Listen, they say, as I tell you things, sweet little things. I woke up to hear knocking on the glass, I can't move, it's hard to breathe, my eyes move but my mouth don't, at least it's not dark. There are pictures of me on the computer screens. People move about the room as if they were little ants. At first, I think is this a nightmare, but it's something worse. Mother has started her experiments again. The crafty little witch tricked me with freedom, but she has induced the addictions again. Dark little monsters travel down the clear line, which feeds my veins. My chemical dreams take over again. What are her plans for me this time, I wonder? How do I still fit into her grand design? Doesn't she have enough monkeys to do her bidding? So many little ants. Mother, mother, I'm here. I manger the whisper to Mr. White. Toxic minds and shadow monsters compromise my will to move to the next room. Life tends to slice the pie into more slices than it should, dividing memories and hopes among the ones that want more but needless. News of wars and protest flash along walls and blending with dancing shadows. Shadows who only seem to stop, only to eat or sleep after Mr. White provides them with a slight prick to the arm. Only a small red dot. But that special kind of magic sends us drifting away to play games with friends we have never met, toward the scarecrow grounds of excised souls. Only to flood our cornfields with hope and fear, as Nancy used to say, the crow comes to eat, it doesn't come to sing. Mr. White took Nancy away, filled her full of shimmering light, evil painful light that twists the minds, it lives inside and eats away good thoughts of the past and bad ones of the future. The light brings the demons and the demons push back the minds of the carbon body they now inhabit. The doctors are mere conjurer of twisted souls and primordial spirits from a time when the earth still glowed bright red, from the embers of creation. Inside the conjurer's box, there are rooms, small little homes for its victims. A witch's box beyond celestial design. Victims must trust their captives, the little red dots and the pinpricks help the new ones. Helps them forget the wires, the modern puppet strings of speak. For we speak the high speech of men, words not known to the normal, for they speak the low speeches of the flies. Nancy became a fly, so she got to fly away, but Nancy lives in the box along with the countless others, twisting and turning in pain along the electric lines of the internet. I found the truth, the night they killed Fred. Fred wasn't like you or I. Not even Mr. White is the other puppets that infect the world like cancer. Hopelessly watching for the next thing or rancid news story, hopeless creatures the humans have become, it's hard to wonder if our creators planned for us to be here, the way that we are. It's hard for me to see the Great One, that is if he is a she and is really there, to say go forth and troll the internet, live through the eyes of others, wish and dream that you had their lives. Everyone lies. They're as crazy if not sadder than most of us. They control the worms and they watch us, as Fred used to say. Others would say he wasn't all here, but he saw the world as it was. A binary databank of ones and zeros, the world sits upon a living computer, it's all metal and wires down below. He would scream when you die, the light you see down that long tunnel, is just the closest power source that your electric field can latch onto. In fact, he used to be one of the puppets, until he found the source code. One dark night, before we knew each other, he banged away on a set of computers that had been coded to hear the whispers in power lines. The local power company had contracted his company, in hopes that he could solve an issue they were having, one that most power companies have. That little flicker you see from time to time. When the light in your bedroom dims a little. His experiments went on for some time and found the flickers, that dimming where screams. Our own power lines have become the human hell. According to him, our soul, if you call it that, becomes trapped circling around the world, and as someone flips on a light or the coffee maker, it grabs a little part of the ones that have passed. Mr. White tried to change his mind and mother felt the life of the monkeys didn't need to know anything past truth or a lie. I was made to watch him smoke and become part of the data bank. Funny how the mind sounds like popcorn popping when they turn up the voltage. One last dance and shake at 220 volts. As Mr. White flipped the switch, I recall him saying, "You can't have a party without a little power," and then it was over as he did his last dance on that embalming table. I watched as devices were built to burn towers so they would fall and crumble onto the blind. I heard the sounds of things that went a-popping. I saw the tears of the crying hit the ground, tears that filled pots of boiling fluid that would only light more fires, fires that would burn along the ground, consuming building after building, mind after mind. The magic of hope became undone. The serpents that held the keys unlocked the doors of time so that the worms can control carbon mines. The puppet masters dropped their cords and lines as we advanced to golden speakers that fit snugly in our ears. "Listen," they say, "as I tell you things, sweet little things."